Good morning, students. And today we discussed about threaded binary tree. So today we see the picture of the presentation of threaded binary tree. See. So what is a threaded binary tree? So actual definition is a binary tree in which each node uses another empty left side link to refer the nodes in order predecessor, and empty right side link to refer to its in order successor. Okay, so in binary search tree, in which each node uses a left link to refer the nodes in order predecessor, and right child link to refer the pre-order predecessor. So this is see the diagram. This one is a simply binary tree. Okay, it has at most two children. Okay, so this can be represented in threaded binary tree in this way. So okay, so see here, A has two connections, B and C. A has two connections, B and C, and B has two connections, D and E, and C has two connections, F and G. And remaining D, E, F, G are the leaf nodes. These nodes are represented with null. So these nodes are represented with null. So what is this? Is a binary tree, but in binary tree, see here, we are replacing the null value, means the wastage of memory will occur here. So instead of placing null, we store some addresses of the nodes. Then it is very easy to traverse the node. It is very easy to traverse the tree by instead of null, we are storing addresses. You can easily traverse the tree in bidirectional. Okay, so that is the concept which comes under threaded binary tree. So in the tree, there are 8 null pointers. See here. Total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, 8 null pointers, and actual 6 pointers are there. So overall 14 points are there. So we can generate it for any binary tree. Okay, we can generate it for any binary tree with n nodes. There will be n plus 1 null pointers. Total we have 2n pointers. Okay, so a binary tree with such pointers are called a threaded tree. What is a thread means? See here. So thread means instead of null, we store some address of the previous node or predecessor successor. Instead of null, we store the address of the predecessor or successor address, predecessor node address or successor address node address. Then we call it as a thread. Okay. So here we have just see here, threaded binary tree has one way threaded binary tree, or two way threaded binary tree, and multi way threaded binary tree, or in order threaded binary tree, pre order threaded binary tree, post order threaded binary tree. Okay. So you just represented any names, but the concept is same. If you consider one way, that means that is if you consider either left way subtree or right subtree. Okay. If you consider two way, you can just consider the right subtree. See here, you will use the right threaded one in this case. See here. In this one way means he represents as right thread. So you just store the right nodes with some predecessor successor addresses. So if you just if you called a one way thread tree or a right thread tree or post order thread tree, any name, the concept is same. And another thread tree is two way thread tree. See here. two by 30 means use left pointer. So store the left means pre-order threaded binary tree or left threaded binary tree or two by 30 binary tree. Okay. Then multi-threaded tree means you just store the address of left and right. Okay. Just see, you can understand. So this is the actual binary tree. Okay, A, B, C, D. So now instead of this, we replace, this is the left pointer, this is the right pointer. This is left address, this is right. So if you use one way, use the only, we are going to connect only right side blocks with some pointer address. Okay. If you connected two way threaded, use only left pointers and right pointers we kept as null. Okay, you just store left null pointers with some predecessor successor address. Okay, clear students? Any doubt? So see students, already I told you, but again I am explaining the concept once again for better understanding. Here we are using one way threaded tree means we will use the right thread only in this case.
Yes.
So you to implement threads, we need to use in order successor. First of all, you have to construct the in order. It means you have tree traversal technique as in order, pre order, post order. For threaded binary tree, just construct the in order thread, in order traversal. So in order traversal means left parent, left root, right. Okay, here what is the left D, then parent is B, then E, C, R, then parent A, then left F, then parent C, then G. So this is the successor. Okay, so you use the one way threaded tree, means just you connect the right nodes with some address. So see here, D is there. So D right side here in order successor represent B. So you store the address of B here. In right link of D, store the address of B. Similarly, E has right link. Here in this in order successor, E has predecessor is A, and you store the address of A. Similarly, F right side is C, store the address of C. So on G, there is no right here. You just kept null. Or you can directly connect the root node. Okay. So this is one way. Then two way, we are using left pointers only. See here. We are connect only left here, left pointer. Just here in this, we connect only left. Or two way means you may connect both, either left and right. So one way first you consider left, and one way consider next left, then two way means you can connect both. See here, I am connecting left node here. There is in B, there is no left here. Directly connected to the parent and CR D has right, we already know. So CR E has left is B, so connect left. F has left is A, store the address of A. So in this way, you have to connect. Okay. So see here what happened here. So here we have in left we are called is dangling pointer. Dangling pointer means it does not contain a valid address. So because valid address means it may not be null or it does not contain any address. So it is called as a dangling pointer. It does not contain a valid address. We call it as a dangling pointer. If it is null, okay, but if it is null, it contains address, but it is not a valid address. That address is not used in any other location. So that address we call it as dangling pointer. So here, here E left and right is connected F left and G. But in we have two nodes are remaining here. One is D left and G right. So to overcome this problem, we are using a header node that is connected to the top of the root node. Then the left and right points of the header nodes are linked to the head. See here, I am taking one head as top of the root. So in this left link of D is connected to head, and right link of D contains remaining as it is. Okay. So in this way, how to purify the danglings? Okay. So see here another one structure of BT. Okay. For the purpose of algorithm, assume each node has five fields. One is left tag and left link data, right link and right tag. So what is left tag and what is right tag? So it is a boolean 0 and 1. See here, if 1 means it is connected, 0 means it contains there are no childs. Okay, so here what we have to do is, here left child is 1 means we have connected with root node, so that is represented in 1. And here right child we represent, we connected G, so we represented 1. So A has 2 connections, B and C, so we represented with 1. And B has 2 connections, D and E, so represented with 1. And C has 2 connections, F and G, we represented with 1, means 2 childs. Okay, so D has no childs here. So that's why I tag as 0. Okay, clear students? So B has no child, so we tag it as 0. Total 5 fields, left tag, right tag. Left tag is, right tag is 1. If there is a child is there, if there is no child, then you just keep 0. So next one is threaded tree traversal. So how we traverse the tree? So after constructing threaded tree, first we start with the leftmost node in the tree and print it and follow its right. So here what we have to do is, here threaded, this is threaded binary tree. We start it from 1. Nothing but you just follow in order successor. So in order successor means, in order traversal means left root, right. So left is 1, here 1, then parent 3, then 5, then parent 6, then left, that is 7, then parent, then 9. Okay, this is in order traversal. So difference between threaded binary tree and normal binary tree. In threaded tree, the null points are used as thread. Thread is nothing but to store the address of some predecessor successor node. But in binary tree, we represent the nodes as null pointers. To store the, if there is no connection, we represent with null. So here we can use the null pointer, which is efficient to use the computer's memory. So here we cannot use the null pointers. So it is a waste of memory. Instead of null, we are placing in threaded memory. So in this, traversal is easy because the addresses of each node may be in predecessor or successor. But here traversal is not that much easy. But the structure is complex in threaded, but it is very less complex than threaded binary tree. So an insertion deletion takes more time, but here less time because it starts from root node and insert in left and right. Okay. Okay, clear students, are any doubt? So here, then we replace the pointers called threads. Already told you. So this is the threaded binary tree. Just represented in this format. Just represented this in this way. This is left wing. This is right wing. Okay, clear students? Or any doubt? See here. Instead of one here, we are causing F. You may be represented 0, 1, or F and T. F means there is a connection is there. T means there is no connection. That is 0. See here. Insertion into A. Insertion of A. Right side of in a threaded tree. So this is one tree. So if you want to insert R, so where you have to insert here? So for this, just you have to insert here and store the address here. If you want to insert R as a right child of S, okay. So in this way you can represent and you store the address here. The find the in order structure, then the left address is stored here, right address is root. The clear students are any doubt? I told you in order successor 6, then 7, then here 9, 8, then 9, 11, 13. Okay. Then next concept is balanced trees. Okay. So for clear students or any doubt? Okay, next one is balanced tree. So just okay. Next we see the balanced trees. 1 minute, I am. Your syllabus here. How many students I am seeing the syllabus? Just wait. Okay, C students here. And see here, what is balanced trees? What is balanced tree means? Here, balanced tree is also binary tree. So one of the balanced tree called as AVL tree. So what is why you will come across the AVL tree? Why we comes about the balancing factor of the AVL tree? Why we will discuss about balancing trees? So balancing tree is nothing but actually what happened is I already told you skewed binary trees. So skewed binary tree is what is for example A, B, C, D. So for this, if you want to visit at D, so you start from A, then B, then C, then D. So up to the end, you have to traverse the tree to search for the item D. So this is one of the disadvantages in searching elements in binary tree when it is a skewed binary tree. So and so on, is there any n value is there here? You want to search means you start from 0th degree to nth degree house to search. So this is one of the disadvantages in searching binary tree. So for this, what he has is he introduced a concept called balanced trees. So balanced trees we call it as a one of the balanced tree we call it as AVL tree. So it is nothing but if you want to rotate this one. So this degree is 0, 1, and 2 degree tree. So search the element at 3. If you want to rotate this to right direction, then what happened? So B has the root there, then left child is A, and this one is C, then this one is D. So what does it mean at degree 0, degree 1, at degree 2 you find the element. So just you rotating the tree, you can the time complexity for searching is decreased. So for this purpose, you are using AVL trees. So AVL tree is nothing but it is a special kind of tree in which it contains balancing factor of each node, that is 0, 1 or minus 1. So balancing factor of AVL tree is either 0, 1 or minus 1. Or it is also called as a height balanced tree. You call it as a AVL tree or height balanced tree, or we call it as a balancing factor. So see here, what is the formula here? Balancing factor equal to height of the left subtree minus height of the right subtree. So height balancing tree means height of the left subtree minus height of the left subtree. Those values contain either 0 or 1 or minus 1. Height of the left subtree and height of the right subtree may contain 0, 1 or minus 1. Okay, clear. That is AVL tree. So AVL contains the balancing factor that may be 0, 1 or minus 1. So what is the balancing, what is the balance factor means? Height of the left subtree minus height of the right subtree. So see here, just now already told you, this is a skewed balanced tree, a skewed binary tree, or binary search trees here. What is, if you want to search the element D, this is right skewed binary tree. So it will take degree 3, 2, 1, 0. So once you rotate, then what happened? It is a balanced BS tree. So balanced BS tree called as AVL tree. So this is unbalanced BS tree. This is a balanced binary tree. So how we convert this balanced to unbalanced binary tree to balanced binary tree? Just BFs here, what we have to do is, we have to consider here, this is left direction, this is right. In left, is there any child is there or any edge is there? No. So zero. Right, 1, 2, 3. Three nodes are, three edges are there. So left subtree minus right subtree, 0 minus 3 is -3. Coming to this node, is there any left? No. And right, 1 to 2 nodes are there. So 0 minus 2 minus. For here, there is no 0 minus 1. So overall, the balancing factor is here -3, -2, -1. So this is not a binary search tree. This is not a balanced. So overall tree contains either 0, 1, or -1. See here, this tree, considering C, C left, is there any child are there? Yes. Left has 1, 2 childs are there. Right has 2 childs, so 2 minus 2, that is 0. For this, left is 0 and right is -1. So 0 minus 1 is -1. Okay, this is a balancing. Here there is no left and right are there, 0, 0. Here right is there, so this is the balanced tree. Okay, clear students, or any doubt? Here this is 2 minus 2. Okay, left 1, 2, right 2 edges, or 2 nodes are there. So it is a stored binary, it is a AVL tree. Now see here, representation of AVL tree. So AVL tree can be represented or implemented as other tree in memory with an additional field for track of balancing factor. We have represent how we represent the tree the same way we represent the AVL tree also, but we have in another field is there, that is BF field, that is balancing factor. Actually in tree we have only left child, right child and information, but here extra field is there, that is balancing factor. So what is balancing factor means? The difference between height subtree, left subtree minus right subtree. So AVL tree is constructed by the same process. Okay, so how we construct the binary tree? Okay, how we construct the binary tree? So how we construct means, we construct the binary tree. See here, just I'm discussing in this only. Then I am explaining AVL tree and constructing binary tree parallelly. Okay. Every time you have to check the balancing factor after inserting the node. So the balancing factor of each node is 0, 1 or minus 1. Okay. See, once you are constructing a BS AVL tree, first you have to know the different type of rotations are there. That is left rotation, right rotation, left-left rotation, right-right rotation, left-right rotation, right-right rotation. Before this, we see the construction of binary tree. Okay. See the construction of binary tree. 1 minute students, stay. Okay, so here there are no one to represent the trees, so I just explain it here. See, I will explain the binary tree with example. Is there any empty nodes or something? Okay, so see here, just I am representing the binary tree. We have so this is the data I am considering here. Okay, for when you constructing the binary tree, okay, so what you have to do, the first node we take it as a root node, that is H is my root node. Then you just insert in direction, left direction, right direction, left. Next one insert is D. Next you are going to insert is D. Next element is D. Insert left side. Next element is I. You insert it right side. Next element is B. Insert left. Next element is E. Insert right. Next element is A. Insert left. Next element is F. Insert right. Okay, at each level you have to insert here in this way. Next here C, insert left, and next level is C, insert right. So in this way you have to construct a binary tree by using directions left, right, left, right. Okay, for example, I want to insert element I want to insert the element Q. So just I give the directions here. I am going to discuss left, right, left, right, left, right. Okay. So here start here, left, right. Okay, one left, right is our next left, right is our next left, right is our next left, right is our. Then this left and right is here I insert. By using directions. Okay, understand students? By using directions, okay, by using directions we can store the element in the tree. Okay, clear? So in this way, how to construct the binary tree. So in the same way, you have to construct the AVL tree by using directions only. When you construct the AVL tree, you have to check that the tree is balancing or not. Okay. So see here, first we have to check the different types of rotations. And after that, we will try one example how we construct the tree and how we construct the AVL tree. So here, this is LL rotation. So in this way, you have a balancing factor problem is there in this way, in this direction. So LL, so here the total left. You just perform rotations only on three nodes only. Just remember that in AVL tree, just perform rotations on only three nodes only. Okay, so this is left LL, only three nodes left rotation. So you see here the balancing factor here. See here in this, the domain nodes is there two, left side two edges are there, or nodes, consider anyone, two edges are two nodes, or two right side, there are no edge, 2 minus 0, 2. And see here, right is 0, left 1 node, 1 minus 0 is 1, here 0 minus 0, 0. So this is not a AVL tree. So, but here the problem is LL rotation. So here LL rotation means just rotate it into right direction. So this is LL problem, and just rotate into right direction. So just rotate here. See here after rotation, check the balancing factor. So this is the balancing factor. So in this way, you have to perform LL rotation. Similarly, RR rotation. First, you have to check the balancing factor where the balance will occur. Then you have to rotate left. See here, RR rotation means rotate left. LL rotation means rotate right. Okay, clear students. And tomorrow we will see remaining left to right rotation and right to left, and then construct the AVL tree or any tree. They will turn binary tree by this example. Tomorrow we will discuss. Anybody has any query, students? Please write a message in chat box. Today we end the class, and tomorrow we will discuss. Thank you.